Hi.
Hi.
You seem to be creating an apple. Is there a Garden of Eden that goes around that somewhere?
Nope, it just, it's just what it is, I guess. It looked like a piece of fruit, so that's what it's going to be.
Wow, I wish I could take a piece of clay and, that is clay?
Yes.
Oh, good. Didn't want to mislead people if it wasn't, and create something like that. I suppose if I tried, I might be able to do that. It's just at the moment, not my medium.
Just takes practice.
Yeah. Yeah, and good hands. Hands that feel the shape, I guess, eh?
Yeah, I actually threw these forms yesterday on the wheel. I'm a potter with the Yellowknife Guild of Arts and Crafts. And we have a studio out in Cam Lake here in Yellowknife. So,
I'm sorry, I got you all going. You didn't introduce yourself yet.
I'm Janice Lee.
Hi, Janice.
Hi, it's nice to meet you.
Potter with the Yellowknife Guild of Crafts.
That's right.
Okay, sorry.
No worries. So, we're a nonprofit organization, and we're all run by volunteers. Like I said, we have a studio out in Cam Lake, and we have, we run pottery programs and, a lot of fiber programs. We have felting and weaving and knitting, and we've got a stained glass program, we've got a bird carving program. We've got a lot of different crafts going on in the one building, and it's kind of a nice place to go to get your creative juices flowing. So I do mostly pottery, but I also do a little bit of fiber art as well.
I see the building. I see the building down there. We're driving past. It's not been there very long, eh?
No, we've been there since about 2007. I think was when we moved in. I don't remember the exact year. Okay. But we used to be. The guild has been around for quite a few years, but we just moved into that building a couple of years ago.
So you mostly do pottery, you say? I mean, the shapes that I see here, they're sculptural in my eye. When I think of pottery, I don't always think of sculptural, the sculptural aspect of it. Do you do more traditional pottery as well?
Yep. Normally, it's functional stuff that I do. Just for today, because I didn't want to bring the wheel in. It's a bit heavy and kind of, I didn't know how the power was going to work out and stuff. I threw these forms beforehand and I'm just altering them today. Okay. But normally I throw plates and bowls and cups and things that you can use around the house.
I guess a good question about the guild's facilities and potteries, how many wheels are there?
Folks can
use if you become a member, and they're available like that collectively to the group?
Yep, the guild runs pottery classes. I think we're on a break right now because it's summertime, but we run classes in the fall and in the winter. We used to have 9 wheels. I think we have 10 wheels now. They're electric wheels. And we run classes usually in the evenings. And then we also run an open studio. If you've taken a class, you're welcome to come back and practice your skills. And the open studios are on Thursday evenings and Saturday and Sunday afternoons.
What kind of kilns do you have? How big are they? How much can you get in at one time?
We've got 3 electric kilns. Not entirely sure about the capacity of them, they're...
Big enough.
Fairly large, yeah. We run them fairly consistently throughout the week. And we've got a pug mill there. We've got, we make our own glazes. Basically a fully functioning studio. It's all run by volunteers, which takes a bit of work sometimes, but everyone pitches in and we make it happen.
That's great. So how can people get in touch with you or the guild?
The guild, we have a website. It's www.ykguild.nt.ca, I believe. And then for myself, I So I can give you my email address.
Well, if you like to, if you sell your work and you want people to be able to get in touch with you.
Well, in terms of sales, the guild runs 2 sales a year.
Okay.
We have a Christmas sale and a spring sale. And we usually run those out of the St. Pat's High School. But starting on June 19th, the Fireweed Studio, just outside of City Hall, will be open again on Saturdays from 11 to 4, I believe it is. And we run every Saturday in the summer and sell our pottery and our different wares out of there. So.
How many members? That's the last question. How many members of the guild are there?
That's a good question.
roughly. I don't expect you to be the secretary who knows all the...
In terms of membership, there's over 100, I believe.
Wow.
But those, you need to be a member to take a class. So people will sign up for classes and become members. But in terms of working studio members in the pottery studio, I think there's probably only about 20 or so.
Okay. But... All right. Thanks. That gives us a little bit of insight into the guild and those what potter around. Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.